crustacean, I guess, or an arthropod, however you want to call it, that's been here since before dinosaurs. And it keeps on going. So what can we learn from that? You know, why hasn't it had to adapt, or why doesn't it have to change to this environment like we do?
Often referred to as living fossils, horseshoe crabs actually predate dinosaurs by 200 million years. And despite inhabiting planet Earth for so long, they've changed very little, including the instinct to come back to the Shark River estuary to spawn.
So today we're going to be tagging horseshoe crabs. We're going to do a demonstration to kind of train people and kind of really engage the community to bring them down here to Shark River estuary. Back in 2003, we started tagging here, and it's kind of blossomed from there. We work with Shark River Cleanup Coalition, who's our partner in this, and they've been tagging with me as well.
Yeah, there you go, right? And then we would put that tag in there like that, and push it all the way down.
It's not uncommon for people to be frightened when handling horseshoe crabs, but in reality, they're completely harmless.
390771.
Press it in, and these are tagged.
So it's a really cool looking, kind of weird species, but people really relate to it, and I think that's the big thing. And it's really cool to see them kind of be okay with it, to know it's right here in their backyard, you know?
So this is a female horseshoe crab. This is its carapace. These are its common eyes. That's its pineal eyes. Okay, this is its telson. It basically uses this to right itself if it gets flipped over. You can see it has gills. It also has a number of legs, 8, and then it has some chelicera. That's pretty much the anatomy of this guy.
The hope for this group is to understand where the crabs go. They have tags that have turned up as far away as Long Island, Delaware, and even Ocean City, Maryland.
That tells you these crabs move, and we kind of want to know what brings them back to Shark River. Why Shark River? Why not Delaware Bay? Why not Raritan Bay? And that's kind of why we've been tagging them.
But more importantly, they need to prove that spawning continues on these Shark River beaches. This might help them gain more protection for the crabs and the estuary, especially during spawning season.
The towns, the five boroughs around here, have kind of united and passed ordinances where they won't mechanically rake the beaches during horseshoe crab season. So the eggs stay there, they can spawn. One municipality actually put new sand on the beach. So they're thinking about the horseshoe crab more. I would like to see more restoration done here for the crab itself too, because these are nice little sandy beaches where these crabs can kind of just tuck in and spawn. My thought is they've been here a long time, let's just keep them here the best we can.